And welcome back to MD Global Muscle here at the Unrise Media Studios with me, your host, Giles Thomas. And we're joined all the way from a hotel in Columbus, Ohio, probably the Hilton, Ron Harris.
It is the Hilton. Thank you, Giles. Thank you.
I recognize the rooms, mate.
Yeah, happy to be here. Happy to be here.
Ron.
Great show.
Oh, mate. Mate, you did a fantastic job. I mean, you pumped out some serious... I'm surprised you actually pumped out so many videos without me being there to challenge you to get more.
I had to try my best, Giles. I had to try. So, yeah, we got a lot of good content.
Good job. Right, so you've just got in. You've been out last night, partying into the wee hours, I think.
You are correct, sir. Yeah. Got in at 3:30. Yeah, up at 7:30. So, you know, that's probably no big deal for you, but I'm an old man. I need my sleep, but I'll be okay.
Okay. Right, so what should we start with? I want to start with... Let's start with the Open.
Yeah.
Because... Yeah, just take us through it, Ron.
Yeah, you know, it was a pretty controversial decision. Mm. You know, we could talk about the whole open class, but the big talk was Bonac versus Curry. And a lot of people had Bonac beating Curry. I was one of them. I was definitely one of them. Not to say that he blew Curry away, but I definitely would have given William Bonac the nod. The last time I saw William at the Olympia a few months ago, I was worried. I thought this was the beginning of the end for him.
Yeah.
Father Time catches up to everybody, and I thought that was the beginning of his downward spiral away from competitive bodybuilding. But no, he started working with Chad Nichols a few weeks ago, and he came in big again, got his size back, nice and he was popping. He was full.
Yep.
And the condition was right bang on. Brandon, on the other hand, was smaller than we've seen him. Condition wasn't quite where we've seen it. It's almost like they I don't think they planned it this way, but it was just enough to barely win and nothing more. As if they were on going in at about 85-90%, whereas they would go in at 100% for the Olympia. So I'm sure you guys, everybody who's watching this has probably been online, and maybe they've even made the comments Bonac was robbed and this and that. So I don't like to use that word robbed, but I would have personally given it to Bonac for the win.
Ron, it was overwhelming, mate. I mean, I've been looking at some of the comments, and you know what? I mean, most fans, I'll be honest, don't have the best eye maybe in some instances. You know, let's just be fair.
Right.
And sometimes people like to jump on the bandwagon because they see everybody else getting outraged by things. But mate, for me, and do you know what? I've got to say this. For the last 5 years, William Bonac, every single year, he's the one guy that people don't... They don't count him in. It's like, oh yeah, he's done. He's not. He's too small. He's whatever. But every single year, pretty much, apart from the Olympia last year, he proves himself. And it's just, I just wonder what this guy has to do to get real respect now, because it's just, I don't get it. I don't get it.
Yeah, you know, we've talked about this before. Sometimes taking second in a show where everyone thinks you should have won can do more for your clout, your stock, than winning the show. I think that's what happened with this Arnold Classic. Everyone is talking about William Bonac should have won. Had he won, of course, everybody would have been, except for all the Brandon Curry fans out there, everybody would have been over the moon, please. Very, very happy for him. But now I think there's a lot more buzz around William because people feel he should have won and he did not get the nod. So this puts him in a great position. I think he's coming to Boston. I think he's coming to my town in a few days.
He's doing it. Yeah, he's doing it. He's down.
Yeah. Well, that's his show. Come on. If he doesn't win that, my goodness. But yeah, I think he's in a great spot now. I think this did a lot for his credibility. People will be talking about him. People won't be writing him off. He's a heavy favorite now for the Olympia.
Mate, I was like you. I mean, I thought, because it wasn't just, it wasn't the Olympia last year. It was the year before as well. I could see he was starting. I thought, okay, he's on the tail end now. Because I always thought he's going to be like Sean Ray. He's going to be a top five, top six guy for as long as, and he has been for the last, 5 years? But yeah. I thought, okay, now he's starting to dip now. Now he's going to get eighth, then he's going to slip to 10th, and then maybe he'll, you know, he's maybe not even going to qualify or something. Do you know what I mean? But like, he's done it. I just want to know what the hell Chad Nichols did with him in 5 weeks.
We'll never know. Yeah. But I'm happy because he's a great guy, and he's very humble. He works so hard. I'm glad to see that he's not done, because he's good for this. I love his physique. He reminds me of Kai Greene in certain poses.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a fantastic physique, and he should have. Can I say it? Yeah, he should have won this Arnold Classic. I mean, I did the wrap up with Milos and Jose, and we were all in agreement. Yeah. We all had him, and it wasn't, you know, highway robbery, a travesty. We're not about to tear the building down or anything, but you know, like you said, anybody. We're not on the bandwagon. We've been to a million shows. We've seen many Olympias, many Arnold Classics, and Bonac really should have won that show last night.
I thought, I watched the wrap up this morning on the treadmill, and I thought Jose looked mad. He looked angry about it.
No, that's,
he did. I thought he was going to kick off. He looked really pissed off.
No, that's his regular demeanor. That's his rest.
Oh no, Jose's not. Jose like that normally.
No, when he's doing commentary, that's you know, women have resting bitch face. They say he has resting bitch attitude. But let's move on to.
Hang on, sorry. I just want to say, I expected Brandon to do what he did in 2019, where he looks. Mm. He always peaks at the night show. Because remember the 2019 Arnold. I gave the prejudging to William Bonac. I said, "Oh no, William's clearly got that." And then remember, Brandon came out at the night, and he just transformed like he did at the Olympia last year. I thought he's kind of like the new Mr. Saturday Night, like Phil Heath was, you know. But when he came out last night, I was like, "Okay, I don't think he even looks as good."
Yeah, I was fully expecting, you know, when I did my wrap ups after the judging Friday night, they've got 24 hour, you know, they've got almost a whole other day to fix this.
Yeah.
Because he looked, I don't think it was a matter of being flat. I think he was a little bit down in size. But the conditioning issue, I didn't know if it was body fat or water. I thought Abdullah could have sorted that in a 20-hour span, 24-hour span. And, yeah, he did not really change much at all. Neither did William, but he didn't need to.
Yeah. William always holds it. But to me, Brandon looks like he did when kind of in probably the 2019, maybe not even as good as when he won the 2019 Olympia. Because in 2020, remember, he came in and he was super sharp and he had the shaved head. And it was like, okay, now he's getting the really dry glutes and the dry legs and the really good separated, you know, the separation and stuff. And I just thought, but I feel like he's kind of regressed a little bit. I mean, maybe like you said, maybe he's just going to go all out for the Olympia. Because, I mean, I was in the run up to this, I was like, okay, Brandon, I think could win the Arnold and the Olympia again this year. But I feel like now he's really going to have to sort of, I mean, he won this by, it's debatable.
Yeah, and you know, we did the interview right after he won, and Abdullah was there, and Ahmad Askar from Kuwait, the Oxygen Gym.
Yeah,
and they kept mentioning that he'd only been, it was a short prep. He got there, and Askar said he looked like me when he got there. And, you know, Askar's a big dude, but he's not a Brandon Curry big dude.
Yeah,
so that let me know that, you know, it was sort of a last minute decision. Didn't put his full time. I'm sure he put plenty of effort into it, but didn't put the full time prep that he normally would have. Abdullah was, you know, I could tell he was smiling at everybody, but he had hoped that Brandon would have been there sooner for the Olympia. He's going to be there probably 16 weeks.
Okay. That's different. Yeah. That's different. Cause I think as a Brandon, he changes fast.
Yeah. Yeah.
He needs more time. Needs more time.
They just did enough for this to barely squeak out a win. Barely. Controversial, very controversial win.
Well, like I said, I'm not dissing Brandon because I love Brandon, but yeah, like I said, I feel like, you know, if you purely based upon what we've seen, this was not the best Brandon I've seen, and I expected him to look different for the Saturday. He didn't. He won because I expected him to actually to pull ahead and win purely because of how much he changes, not how he looked based upon the Friday. Because I've seen him do this. He's done this before. He's done it at the Olympias. He's done it at the Arnold Classics. So anyway, okay, so we'll move on to Steve Kuklow in third.
Yeah, Kuklow looked great. Tighter than he was at the last Arnold. Condition was bang on. I've seen him a little bigger and fuller, but not as conditioned. I thought this was a great look for Steve. And to take third in this Arnold Classic, even though he just took third 5 months ago at the Arnold Classic, this was obviously up against a Mr. Olympia champion and a two-time Arnold champion. So even though the placing is the same, he did look better here. I give him a lot of credit because after the judging Friday night, there was a lot of buzz around Justin Rodriguez for third.
Yeah.
Everybody was talking about Justin, how big and full he looked and ripped and confident on stage. And, you know, not many people were talking about Kuklow. So for Kuklow to come in and beat Justin Samson, we'll get to that. But, you know, props to him. Kuklow is holding his own against these guys.
Was this the best Kuklow ever? Ever?
It's, if not, it's very, very close. Mm. I don't know what's the best Kuklo. I liked him a lot at that Texas Pro last year. I liked him at the Arnold last year.
Yeah, but then again, he's not up against the same guys, and the Texas Pro had incredible lighting where everyone just looked sensational. Right. And it's like he's not. Do you know what I mean? I think maybe. Yeah, yeah. I don't know. I'm going to have to really go and analyze it. But some people, like Milos, said that this was the best Kuklo he'd ever seen.
Yeah. It's hard because Steve has been so good so many times.
Yeah.
He's got that problem of being so good that it's hard to say which one was his best.
Yeah.
It's hard to pick. He looked fantastic. You know, congratulations, Steve.
Yeah.
Because not many people were talking about him for the show. Not many at all.
I know. And then he was a bit ill, and then it was like we were posting videos, and I was thinking, is that an old video, or is this a red flag? So Kuklo, yeah. Personally, I had on day one, I thought Justin Rodriguez was a clear lock for third, but he always does this at the Arnold Classic. He always looks great on the first day, and he always seems to fade on the second day. And he seems to sort of fill himself out, and he gets a bit of a stomach issue. And he always looks, he always comes on. It's like Bonac always looks, he always holds his condition on both days. You get guys like Brandon who look good at the pre-judging and then great on the second day, and then you get guys like Rodriguez who look incredible on the first day, and then the second day they kind of slip down. Because I thought he was a solid lock for third. I messaged Samson. I said, look, mate, this is, you know, you could potentially beat Kuklo for fourth here, mate. And it was the other way around.
Yeah, the biggest issue I saw with him is what you said, is on the second night he seemed to have a lot of trouble holding his midsection in. At certain times, it was starting to bulge out, and it takes away. You know, Jose, maybe you can figure this out. Jose, in the wrap-up with Milos last night, was saying there's something about his physique. I can't quite put my finger on it, but something isn't quite right. Something doesn't really flow. He couldn't figure it out. I'm kind of at a loss, too. You know, people talk about the jimmied up shoulders. I don't know if they're just enormous shoulders. But
yeah.
I mean, his legs could probably be a little bigger, but I just can't put my finger on why. What could I pick apart about his physique? And it's hard because he doesn't have really weak body parts. It's just things don't really flow the way you would want them to in an ideal world.
I think in some poses, like the most muscular, the front lower bicep, his flow is perfect. It's like he looks great. It's like if Brandon, the readable bicep, you know, the posterior chain kind of ruins that pose a little bit, you know, unless he's really conditioned and you're just like blown away by the condition. But with Rodriguez, he looks great in some poses. In other poses, the flow isn't as good. But frontal bicep, I thought, was the best in the show.
Yeah, yeah. He's got I love his frontal bicep pose. It's that weird angle that he hits it at. It's beautiful.
It's incredible.
If I had to pick one thing, maybe it's, you know, the triceps are supposed to be twice as big as the biceps. In his case, I think they're about equal. He's got these enormous biceps, and his triceps could be bigger. I'm really getting nitpicky here, but you have to at this level. These guys are all so phenomenal. You have to look at the tiniest little flaws, if you will, or imbalances.
I thought his legs were bigger.
Yeah, his legs were bigger. I thought even Brandon's legs looked a little bit bigger. I didn't see too many people that had downsized. I guess we'll get to the ones that did, but no, he looked really good, but I have no problem. I had no problem at all with Kuklo beating you.
Yeah. So I've just interviewed literally minutes before you came on. I've just spoke to Samson. So, I mean, for me, I was just jumping in the up and down this morning when I saw the result. When I saw that, I was like, that's fourth place. It's first Arnold Classic. What was he like in the flesh, mate?
Yeah, I mean, the full round muscle bellies were really astonishing to see. I hate to compare people to Flex Wheeler because everybody does that, but I did see some similar attributes, just the way the muscles sort of jumped off the bone.
It flows. He flows.
It's a beautiful, beautiful physique, and he was 200 pounds, I think he said.
He's 10 pounds heavier than he was in last November. And the thing is, Ron, I stayed at his house, 2 weeks ago? And and then in the morning he says he just did his like 45 minutes of cardio. He hadn't had any food yet, and he says he says I'll post for you. So he posed, and then Marlenka was filming it, and I just thought it's funny because she had the cat at the phone there as well filming, and you look at him on the phone and he looks good, but then you see him in the flesh and he's absolutely huge. He really does look 280, 270. I mean it's deceiving because he's kind of an aesthetic guy, but he's 280 pounds.
Right. I mean, how often do you see that? So I think he was the heaviest guy in the show, I believe.
Yeah, he would have been. Yeah, he would have been. Because what was, Rodriguez would have been 260, late 260, maybe 270 max. So yeah, he would have. The thing is, I mean, that's what I said to him in the interview. I said, now that you've stood next to big mass monsters like Steve Kuklo and Justin Rodriguez, now I think people will realize just how large, how much space you take up.
Yeah. You know, I'm so glad he did this show because, number one, he got over here in the States where there's more eyes on you, obviously. There's a lot more coverage for the U.S. shows. And it was the Arnold Classic.
Yeah.
He had never been in this quality lineup before. And that was the proving grounds is what, you know, he took second at the Arnold UK and he won the Prague show, right?
Yep.
But I mean, who did he stand next to? Who did he really beat? No one at this caliber of, he wasn't up there with a Brandon Curry, a Bonac or a Kuklo.
It was like Regan and Raphael, guys like that, you know, no disrespect, but obviously they're not top six Olympia guys.
So now, I mean, everyone was talking about him. I'm sure his Instagram is doubled in followers. Yeah. I mean, everyone was taking note of this guy and saying, wow. Because, you know, the true fans already knew who he was, but there's a lot of casual fans that they only follow a few people. Like, you know, I hazard to say this, like the kids that love Nick Walker and Hunter Labrada, a lot of them don't follow anybody else.
Yeah.
But now they all know who Samson is, and he's got their respect. He's got our attention. It's only up from here. I would like to see I'd like to see a little better condition from the back, mm-hmm. a little bit more back thickness.
Yep.
And I think he's going to be pushing for titles like this very soon.
Well, I said after the after his season at the end of last year, I said said on the forum, actually the MD forum, I said I'd like to see a bit more chest and back on him. And then when I went down to his house a couple of weeks ago and he posed, I could see his chest was a lot thicker, like his side chest, his upper chest was as thick as his lower chest, which is, you know, that's the holy grail, isn't it, of like what you want. I could see there was more going on. His arms had, like, were just wider. You know, there was more sort of width, like in his side chest, his triceps went back further. They took up more space. And I could see his legs were a lot bigger. And his rear lat spreads improved, but I would still like to see a tiny bit more back thickness. I think it would make his frontal bicep, his front lat spread even better. And I think it would just make that readable bicep, because I think he's got the potential to have a spectacular readable bicep, but he's just nearly there. But he's, like I say, now he's got 8 months for the Olympia because he's already qualified.
Yeah. I mean, the first time, I've only seen him compete once, and I think it was 2 years ago at Chicago Pro, Tampa. I think it was Chicago.
Vancouver?
Was it Vancouver?
2019.
I don't know. I wasn't overly impressed with him back then, but this is a totally different Samson. He is so much better now, and he's getting better.
Yeah.
You know, credit to Milos, they're making improvements. That's what it's all about. A lot of these guys that we see in these shows, they're maxed out. They've been doing this a very long time. They look great, but they're not going to get any better. Samson gets better and better, and I'm excited for him, very excited. Fourth place, I mean, in this lineup, he should be very proud of himself.
With Samson, it's the only time I get excited about a guy doing a vacuum, because vacuums, I'm not bothered about them. But when you think of that as a guy at 280 with a little waist, there's a tiny little waist and all those proportions, and he's hitting a vacuum easily. I mean, for me, it's similarities with Sean Roden, Flex Wheeler and Chris Cormier. I think if you took all the elements of this physique and put that together, you'd get Samson Dauda.
Yeah. And, you know, he's qualified for the Olympia, as you said.
Yeah.
And in the past, had he been heading into the Olympia in the past, nobody would have been expecting anything from him. They said, well, that's one of the guys that won't make the top 15.
Yeah.
Somebody's got to be like the last or second to last. It's probably this guy, Samson from UK. He's got a conversation now. People are going to be talking about him as a front runner, top 10 for sure. Mm-hmm. You know, who knows? We'll find him. It's still 9 months away, I know. But
I mean, you've got like a top six Olympia guy like Steve Kuklo, and he was 3 points behind Steve Kuklo. So if you want to gauge it by doing that with, you know, how he compares to the top six Olympia guys, he's right there. And who knows what he, and if you see how much improvements, I mean, I was at Romania and I saw him, and then I saw these pictures, and what I saw a couple of weeks ago at his house, completely different. So imagine if he does, and the thing is, he's so hungry and he's so, like, even when I stayed at his house, it was like, his energy is unbelievable. And I went, because half 12, it was like half 12, quarter one, I said, Samson, mate, you're on prep. Because we're chatting in the kitchen. I says, mate, your energy's, you need to get to bed, because he had his cardio at like 7 a.m. because he said, oh, I've got to come in the room, he says, because I've got to get the treadmill, because I was staying in the spare room. And he says, don't mind if I knock on the door, I've got to do my cardio. And I said, yeah. I said, you're only going to get 5-6 hours sleep. I said, mate, get yourself to bed, because his energy is incredible. So unbelievable result for Samson. Very, very happy. So, yeah, we spoke about Justin Rodriguez. And then what about sixth?
So Brett Wilkin, you know, I saw a lot of comments that, oh, Brett was overhyped. You know, a lot was expected of him, a lot. And I feel bad in the sense that when so much is expected, when, you know, we were talking about him pushing Brandon for the win a few days ago. You know, when we did our previews, we were talking about it.
Yeah.
But we had never seen him in this caliber lineup. I don't see it as a fail for him at all. I think he's getting better and better. He has work to do. He needs to bring up his legs. He needs more size and more separation in his legs. Little bit more size in the upper bicep, and he'll be right there. But he, his condition was bang on.
Was it?
Yeah, he was. He was. His really? Boots were in.
Are you sure? Yeah. Are you sure?
Man, I wasn't that close. I was three rows behind the judges last night.
I'll be honest. I'll be perfectly honest. What I saw, I was impressed. He had a fantastic physique. After what we saw last year with Phil Klahar, Austin Carr, Antoine Vallant, you know, the couple of years ago, I'm very interested to see what he does for the Boston Pro, because I think a few tweaks, I think he'll have a horrible week. He's going to have a hell of a week, but I'd like to see what he could do in the next week, because that, I think he could really pull it out the bag for next week, because I think it was conditioning. For me, it was doing his most muscular. I thought he's nearly there. Everything's there. He just needs to get a little bit sharper.
Yeah, I could see that, but I really think a little more leg size is gonna help him a lot.
Okay.
He's up against some guys with phenomenal legs up there, and he put this size on so quickly. It's a new thing. This is a guy that he's about, what is he, about 250 on stage now, 260. This is a guy that turned pro at 190, 95 pounds.
Classic.
Not that long ago, yeah.
It was classic in 2018. 2019, he was 212. And then he came into Chicago last year at 242, which is 30 pounds heavier. I mean, even if he was on the limit at 212, he's going to be, he was a legit, in 2 years, 30 pounds heavier. Now he's coming in with probably, I think he was about 250. So he would have been 8 to 10 pounds heavier, all in, you know, all being said. So, yeah, he's progressing fast. He has got huge potential, I think. But, I felt bad for him actually a little bit. I think that, like you said, there was sometimes with these progress pitches, it can, you know, it's, you know, people kind of get excited. And I think also with what Nick Walker did last year, I think it's put too much expectation on the new guys.
Correct. You know, this was a much tougher lineup. This was a much tougher Arnold Classic lineup than we had 5 months ago. Mm. You know, Jose said it in the wrap up last night. He actually agreed with you. He wasn't thrilled with Brett's condition, but he chalked it up to the fact that this is brand new muscle. And a lot of times when you add new muscle tissue, it's harder to condition it. You're doing it. You're just trying to hold on to it the best you can for the contest. You know, he's still a relatively young guy. I say relatively young. He's only like 32. He is a young guy.
The baby.
But like I said, this is just the beginning. It's his second open show. You know, people expect so much from everybody these days. And like you said, when we see these update pictures, it's that person by themselves. And at this level, every man in this lineup, if you saw their update pictures and you didn't know who they were up against, you would assume they'd win. They look fantastic.
Yeah, I'd like to see Brett do a couple more shows. He's going to do the Boston. Maybe he does the Indy or the New York Pro. I think he could. I still think he could get a win this year. I think it's just conditioning. I think he could tighten up, and I think he could get a win, and I think we could see him at the Olympia. But I hope he does more than just the Boston Pro, because maybe a week's not enough, you know. But I think he could do it. I think he's you know, like you said, it's a big step up from Chicago Pro to the Arnold Classic, and like I said, all this new muscle. But I've still got very high hopes for him this year.
Yeah, I mean, we've yet to see the best of Brett Wilkin.
Oh, you know, he barely got started.
Scratching the surface of his potential, as far as I'm concerned.
Okay, well, I want to go on to the other categories quickly before I let you go in, say, 10 minutes or whatever. The Classic. That was obviously huge, going from 7K to 60K first prize money. It attracted the big names. Take us through it.
Yeah, this was a fantastic lineup. It was the top five from the Olympia, minus Chris Bumps. They were all in the show. Nobody in that lineup was a slouch. I mean, it was a very, very high-quality lineup. Ruffin did win convincingly, I thought. I mean, I don't think anyone was close to him. Not even Ramon Roca, not even close. Although that guy's going to be so good. He's getting better and better. But Ruffin, I love his condition, the shape, the presentation.
Incredible.
You know, that, he is the poster boy, well, along with Bumstead.
Yeah, yeah.
Physique.
Yeah.
I mean, when you think of classic physique, that's those are the qualities I think about, is that beautiful structure, the real dense quality muscle, and the presentation. You know, you're a big fan of posing. Oh. People who actually put a lot of time and effort into making a great presentation for the crowd. Mm. And he did. And he got didn't he get some money for that? Yeah, he got an extra $10,000.
$10,000.
Yeah. But yeah, it was a clear victory. I didn't see anyone close to beating him at the show.
Yeah.
But he's convinced. I'm very excited for the Olympia this year.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I don't know if Bumstead's going to get any better. He's starting to accumulate injuries. I don't know. But it could be his year. Could be Ramon's year. Ramon's got 9 months.
I was impressed with Ramon on the second day. Sorry, at the finals. I was really impressed with what he brought on the finals, because I was looking at the pictures coming in. I was like, holy shit, he's really pulled it out the back. And he's only, what, 24?
Something like that. He's very young.
He's a kid. And the thing is, I saw him at Spain last August, and I wasn't blown away. I said this in the preview. I wasn't that blown away by him. And then he went to the Olympia, and I was like, who's this? And then I realized it was the guy that I'd done commentary on a few weeks before, and he hadn't stuck in my mind as anything that would be remotely considerate for top five Olympia. And then he's just come in this year, and I even saw him at the start of his prep, and I was just like, eh. But he just transforms, this kid. And I'm really impressed. I was actually hoping that Urs would get second, but based upon what Ramondino did in on the finals, I can see why he did get second, and I'm very impressed.
Yeah, I don't think Ramon's been training that long. I want to say it's only been I think he's only been training with weights for like 5 years.
Oh, come on. I hate this guy.
I know. But yeah, beautiful genetics, beautiful shape, structure. I think his posing needs work on some of his mandatory poses. It doesn't quite hit his, doesn't really open up enough on the front double bicep. He sort of leans over on his side chest. There's just a couple little tweaks that would hit him a lot. It wouldn't have given him the win last night necessarily, of course, but you know, this is a guy where people are already talking about. This guy could beat Urs and Ramon are two people they're talking about pushing Bumstead out of his throne.
Wow.
That's crazy. They're all young. These guys are all in their 20s, all of them.
Yeah. I'll be honest, Urs really impressed me. I was very impressed with him. I was absolutely blown away with what he brought, because like I said, he's another guy like Ramon who's coming up fast, you know, and it's like the 1 and 2 at the Olympia this year, it could be two different guys. That's what I think we're headed, what potentially we could be headed towards if Terrence and Chris Bumstead don't bring their absolute best.
Yeah. Well, I don't foresee that happening, but yeah, I mean, it's going to be a very, very tight classic physique Olympia. This is going to be hard to judge. With Urs, I love Urs. He's such a good kid. He's always smiling. Great, great energy. Just always in a good mood. His posing is captivating to watch. I just want to see a little more size in the upper body, particularly the back and the arms. Mm. And he's going to be right there. His condition was great. I would have had no problem with him in second until the second night. Ramon did kind of impress me a little bit more.
I think Urs's lower body, I mean, the condition in his legs, I mean, you cannot literally get drier or harder. It looks like they're just permanently flexed. It's like they're always, I've never seen him. I don't think I've ever seen him with his legs relaxed. He must have them. He's like Lila Brady, must be permanently flexing and keeping it tight. That's incredible for someone so young to be that polished on stage.
We've said this before, you know, muscle maturity is something we say takes years and years and decades. He's 20. I thought he was already 24. He's still 23.
What? Thing is, like you said, the muscle maturity. And then along comes Urs and completely blows it out the water. You know? I mean, thing is, it's absolutely incredible. Imagine being 23 and being that good. And, you know, it's...
Can you imagine Urs at 27, 28 years old?
Wow.
30 years old?
It's phenomenal. Phenomenal. Right. Quickly just touch on some of the other winners and categories. Can we talk quickly about the fitness quickly?
Yeah, that was an upset, because you know Missy Truscott, the only person that's beaten her in recent memory to me is Whitney Jones, so I assumed she was going to win this hands down.
I did.
Does. you know, physique wise, she's got, he could probably be a very top women's physique pro if she wanted to, or figure. I don't.
She's done figure. Missy's done figure, isn't she? She a couple of years ago, she was doing figure and then alternating at shows. So she's, for me, I thought a condition was, I've seen a condition slightly better.
Yeah, but you know what? I don't know how lean fitness is supposed to be. I don't know if they're supposed to be all cross-striated and everything.
I'm saying compared to how I've seen it before.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So, yeah, wasn't quite as lean, but Ariel Kader, you know, props to her because she's been knocking on this door for a while.
Yeah.
Was she second at the last? She was third at the last Olympia, I think.
Mr. Lauren? She was very high-placed.
She's very high.
She's one of the one of the top ladies.
Yeah. She's just been like right on the edge of winning shows many, many times, big shows like this. So I'm very happy for her because, you know, Missy's got a lot of wins, a lot of big wins. This was Ariel's first really big win. She's still a kid. She's like, what is she, like 27, 28, something like that.
She's in her 20s, mid-20s.
He turned pro at 17 years old. That's a true story. They said Bob Ciccarillo talked. She was 17 years old when she turned pro. And
But under the new rules, she wouldn't even be allowed to compete, let alone get a pro card. It's like no under 18s now in the...
That's right.
Yeah. So I wonder if it's... Does that apply to all categories?
Yeah. Well, in the NPC, you can no longer compete unless you're 18.
There you go.
NPC world, doesn't matter if it's US, worldwide, you have to be 18 to compete now.
Hang on. Remember the first bikini winner was Nicole Negroni. She was 18 when she won the Bikini Olympia. So how would she even have got to the stage? She'd have to have had a very successful first year on stage, you know? Imagine that, when competing your first year and you win the Olympia.
Yeah, I have issues with that. I don't think there should be an Olympia champion that's only 18 years old, because how long did it take you to get to that level? And it couldn't have been that long if you're only 18.
Ron, do you remember at the after party? And she walked into the cabana, and I said, and I shouted out, I was a bit drunk. I was Yumi, Kevin Navarone, Zach Khan. And I said, you're not even old enough to be here. And she went, shh, like that, shh. And then she went off. I didn't see her after that. So I was like, because obviously in 21, I was like, that was 12 years ago now. But anyway. And actually, I remember seeing that 14-year-old girl who won the bikini at the Arnold Europe in 2011.
Yeah.
They changed the ruling then, actually. After that, they changed it to 16. They said no under 16s.
I mean,
winning.
I mean, that's so young, so young.
I know. She's a good physique as well.
Figure, who won figure?
Sydney Gillen.
Sydney Gillen, that's right. I'm still a little foggy.
Shocker, yeah, shocker.
that was a done deal. As soon as I saw her name on the list, I mean, okay, well, there you go. There's
incredible.
Your winner.
She's incredible.
Before she even came near the stage, that was the winner. She's the poster child for figure.
And I was impressed with the new, I've never seen this Lola who came third. I've never seen her before, but she really stood out. When your pictures are coming through, I was like, shit, she's good. I don't know this lady. She was really good. Jessica in second was very, very good. Some of the quads are getting a bit big though for me. I feel like they're getting, if you look at figure 10 years ago, it's unrecognizable now. I mean, I suppose that's just how it's progressed.
Oh, wait till we talk about men's physique.
Oh God, they were huge.
There was one of the guys who took eighth, or who took near the bottom of the spot, was enormous. He was 212. Like he could be a 212 bodybuilder.
Do you think they need to have like a classic kind of weight limit cap or restriction, or do you just think just don't let the big guys win?
That's what happened. They didn't. You know that guy. Okay. Sir, whoever you are, I'm not picking you. This is not a personal attack. But yeah, that division was never meant to be about huge muscles. It was meant to be a quote-unquote beach body. It was supposed to be something that was attainable, you know, something.
I've seen a show years ago, an amateur show, and there was the guy who got third compared to the guy who won. It was like the guy who won was like his little brother, like his little teenage brother that he took to the gym, who had very little muscle, and the guy who got third was massive. And I was like, I'm glad to see that, because it shouldn't be about the biggest. You know, it's all about chest and abs, good taper, wide shoulders, V-shaped back. They shouldn't be like you said, like 250 pounds. I've seen guys at the Arnold Classic and the amateur, massive. They must have weighed 120 kilos.
Yeah. Oh, this particular lineup, I mean, the back, they all had great backs, like thick from spinal erectors, lats, rhomboids, everything, traps, busting up, shoulders out to here. They were massive, these guys.
They need to dial it back.
But like you said, I think the judges are doing a good job with not scoring those guys who are extremely massive. They're not putting them in the top spots at all.
Yeah. Ron, can we quickly talk about the wheelchair? Gabriel, I can't remember his last name, because he's...
Andriuli.
Yeah, the Italian, because I've seen him. Dorian Yates has been training him.
Correct.
In Spain.
I think he's a local trainer now in Italy. But yeah, that was a well-deserved win, and it was shocking because I don't know how many times I've seen Harold Kelly win. I've probably seen him win a dozen shows at this point.
Yeah.
Five Olympias, I think, four Arnold Classics. So when you see his name on the list, you're like, okay, well, it's Harold Kelly's going to win again.
Yeah.
And, you know, he's a great guy. I love Harold.
Awesome.
You know, great attitude, perfect ambassador. But I was so happy to see someone else get a chance to get that spotlight and that prestige. And Gabriel really deserved it. He brought the condition. And Harold, I've never seen Harold shredded, but I've seen him much leaner than this.
I have.
Than
he was. I have. I mean, for me, he's like the Sidney Gillen of wheelchair, isn't he? Just like you, right. You see the name and like, okay, everyone's fighting for second because he's really impressive. But I have seen him. I have seen him slightly harder. But the thing is, I mean, what these guys go through, you know, just to get on stage and actually look muscular and be able to train, and it's just incredible. What was the last other category? Was there anything else you want to talk about before I let you go? Wellness. Bikini and wellness quickly. Very quickly.
Yeah, I mean, I was a little shocked. Not really shocked. I thought Ashley Kaltwasser would have been at least second. She was down in fourth, I think it was.
Third.
But, you know, was it third?
Yeah.
Lauren would know. But I was very happy. You know, Laura Lee Chapados is on a roll. I think she's rolling all the way to the Olympic title this year. It's.
Oh, wow. Okay. That'd be good.
I don't see anyone beating her at this point. They love her look. Mm-hmm. Bikini is that one of those divisions I could not judge. To me, they all look perfect. I don't know how the judges make the distinctions between this one and that one, because to me, they all look amazing. But Laura Lee's got it down pat. She's got the physique, the presentation, every little detail, the hair, the makeup, the whatever, the walk.
wellness, quickly.
Yeah, wellness. What was the name of the winner?
Issa Perennis won. Yeah. Narishna was in fifth.
Yeah, I didn't quite get that. I thought Narishna would have been pushing for the win. Mm. You know, wellness was the only division where in the judging, nobody was really moved around at all. I was like waiting. I was like, are they going to put somebody in the middle? Are they going to do something? No. People barely got moved. So, and I'm still struggling to figure out how it's judged exactly. Mm. What determines a winner versus someone that's not winning? And I can't quite get it yet. I'm trying. I'm getting there.
Ron,
congratulations.
I'm going to let you go because I've got somebody else on in literally 3 minutes, and I want to get a very nice, easy run through today. But yeah, great job, mate. And I really hope I'm at the Olympia with you, mate, because I was honestly a bit down this weekend, mate, watching. I was a bit down seeing you, and I was like stroking my phone,
better,
crying, you know, playing Michael Bolton music.
If it makes you feel any better, I had at least 40, 50 people this weekend come up to me. Where's Giles? When's Giles getting here?
He owes me money. Where is he?
Yeah, no. They want, you have a lot of people were hoping to see you and wanted to see you. So when you do come back here, hopefully at the Olympia at the latest, maybe earlier, who knows? But I mean, you're going to get a lot of love here. Let me tell you.
I'm going to be like an energizer bunny at the Olympia, mate. I'm just going to be like a man possessed because I've been kept away for so long, you know? So, but yeah. So, okay then. Well, thank you so much for taking the time, Ron. I really appreciate it, mate. And I love this new iPhone you got. It's just, I feel like I could reach out and stroke your face.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, go ahead. Look at it. There's all the pimples and pockmarks. Here we go. So, yeah, thank you, Giles. Thanks for having me.
Okay, then, Ron, thank you so much for coming to MD Glove Muscle, and I'll speak to you very soon. All right, thanks, Ron. And welcome back to MD Global Muscle here at the Unrise Media Studio with me, your host, Giles Thomas. And we're joined all the way from Columbus, Ohio, the morning after the Arnold Classic, the fourth place new superstar, Samson Dauda! Oh, my God!
Oh, thanks, guys, man. Thanks, man. Honestly, this is still just so real to me, man. Wow, I mean, I'm over the moon. I mean, we couldn't have asked for a better first time in Arnold weekend, man. We couldn't ask for first time. You know, it's just the way everything goes down, man. I'm like, wow. So grateful, man. So grateful.
Samson, before I say anything else, I think we need to do this. Okay? Okay. Yeah! Sorry. Lauren actually went out this morning and got those because we felt
needed. Oh, wow.
We felt that it needed. God, they stink.
Wow.
We felt that it needed a real. I mean, mate, fourth place. And what did I say to you?
Yeah. Oh man, I'm just wow, man. You did say that you think you know I'll definitely gonna crack, you know, try to crack that top five, but. You know, seeing it happen in that lineup is like, wow, you know, what more can you ask for, really?
I mean, I said to you before, I said when I came down to see you the week, I said, look, you know, you've gone to another level by winning a pro show last year and obviously qualifying for this year's Olympia. I said, then you got the invite to the Arnold Classic. That's another level up in itself by just getting the invite. Now you're like, you're top four. Arnold Classic guy, and you're really nipping on the heels of guys, top six Olympia guys like Steve Kukla. You were 3 points behind.
Wow, man. I mean, seriously, who would have seen this coming to this show, especially like, you know, especially at the start of last year, you to say, oh man, by this time next year, this guy is going to be here doing this. Everyone like, yeah, I don't see it happening. I definitely didn't see it happening, you know, and to be here now after all that, wow. I couldn't be more grateful. I couldn't be more, feel more blessed. I mean, seriously, you know, we worked so hard, we put so much time into it. And now to be finally coming to our own, it's like happiness and joy doesn't quite explain it, honestly. You know, even like the first time for me doing a 2-day show, you know, never didn't know how that was going to work, didn't know how that was going to react.
That's true.
So it was like, okay. This is going to be a really good experience going to the Olympia later on in the year. So, you know, take it as that, you know, see how your body responds. Let's learn from this whole thing. Now, not only would you just get the chance to stand next to those top guys, you also get to see, okay, how do you work in a 2-day show event? Mm-hmm. How can you really pick twice in how everything else? And we got a lot of answers this weekend, a lot of information, and we learned a lot. And it's like, wow, okay, we've seen what we can do now, especially in this short space of time, you know. It's crazy, honestly. We just so happy about it.
Were you happier how you looked on day one or day two?
Man, day one, it was almost like we were so happy about day one. We were like so happy and excited about day one. We're like, yes, we nailed it. Yeah, let's go. And then we were like, okay, what can we do for day two? It's like, okay, we're neither coming better or the same, okay? So what can we try to do? What can we try to do for day two? So we're like, okay, let's try to, you know, come in a little bit drier. Let's come in a bit. Let's see if we can really, you know, push it. Let's just, you know, don't, no matter what, you can't go backwards. You just can't go backwards. So try to go. So we're like, okay, we tried it. We tried to ride out some more for the second day. And, you know, we looked at it. We're like, man, I can't believe it, but you're actually better. Like, you're actually better today. And I was like, wow, okay. So coming on stage, he was like, you had that confidence. And for me, seeing what happened on day one and then looking back at the pictures and looking back at everything, because obviously coming into the show, you really didn't know where you stood. You didn't know. You've never stood with these guys before. You didn't know what you would look like next to them. So coming off stage on day one and then people showing you go, that's what you look like. Mm. That's what you look like. This is what we saw. Day two then gave me so much confidence, so much feel like, yeah, okay, I know now. So you coming out on stage for the day two event and there was just so much more, yeah, okay, I know what I'm bringing. I feel excited about it. And the confidence just felt great. The atmosphere felt awesome. And I was like, okay, time to enjoy this and, you know, really take it all in and actually enjoy it, you know. So, yeah, it was absolutely awesome.
I love that video that Milos posted, I think, today with the where you were at the, what, it's not the powerhouse gym, it's called something else now. You were posing. I couldn't believe how you'd actually, because I saw you at your house, you posed in front of me, what, two, three weeks ago. And I was like, okay, I see a lot of added fullness, but I just hoped that you were going to retain it. And you did. You really did. In the chest, especially in the arms and your legs. I mean, your legs are just like next level now.
Yeah, because that was our first carbing up on water loading there. And that was like literally, we woke up flat that morning, like completely flat that morning. It was like, okay, your first carb loading day. I mean, it was kind of like put the food in and everything else. And it was like, okay, come to the gym. We'll do a pump-up workout and so get the blood flowing and everything else. And we kind of were doing that. And we was like, freaking dude, you're just sucking in like a sponge.
Yeah.
And you're just going up. But by the end of the workout, we were so shocked about how full and everything we looked. And he was like, you know what, just quickly, I got to do a video of this and everything else. So we did that video at the time. Just go to the poses. And we were so shocked about how full we looked at that time. We're like, okay, you're completely waterlogged right now. You're completely filled out. But the way you can still hold that and look right at this point, we're like, man, and this is before you even drop the water or anything like that. We were like, okay, we managed to go from bringing you down, taking you back up, and you still kept that fullness and that fresh look even through that whole process. So we were just excited. We're like, okay, if we can nail this right, you know, if we just nail it right, this is going to be something special, you know. And it just, I mean, what just, we just, amount of what happened, we're like, wow, you know, seriously, we couldn't be proud of it.
I think this is your best package by far, definitely.
Oh, by far, you know. Like I said, coming to this show, we said, look, we're 10 pounds heavier than we did in November. You know, everyone was like, yeah, but I'm like, well, I can show you, but this is it. It's not, you will see it. You know, we're going to be harder. Okay, yeah, but let's see. You know, so when you then walked out on stage and people saw it, they were like, holy, whoa, what just happened? And we were like, well, we sort of were saying that coming that we've improved so much in that short time. And, you know, it was kind of like more of a shock of people. I'm like, well, we did sort of see that. We're like, okay, well, is it going to be enough when you stand next to those guys to really, we didn't really see it?
I think because now you've stood next to people like Justin Rodriguez and you beat him and Steve Cooklow, I think in this show, I think people are finally starting to realize just how big you are.
Yeah. And this is the, because we always say, like, for time, we always say, like, you know, you see the pictures on Instagram there, and we always feel like pictures and videos have never done us justice.
Samson, I was at your house, and it's funny because Marlenka was filming, and then she was showing me, and I was tilting my head and looking at the camera, and then I was looking at him, I was thinking, it doesn't translate to the video. It's like, he's huge.
Yeah, he never does us justice. So when we post our updated pictures and videos, I feel like, yeah, he's big, he's doing, and we're like, honestly, wait until you see it in person, because we know whatever you see on Instagram, the real version of it is just so much more. And we kind of thrive of that, because we're like, look, this way, I'd rather it be this way, that they see the picture, they go, okay, he's good, but whatever, and then they see you, realize, go, holy shit, I didn't realize you were that big. I didn't realize. And we're like, well, this is what brought. So coming into this show, you know, we saw, you know, we had a little footage we dropped here and there, and people were like, okay, he's on, he's this, he's that. And then, but then when you come out on the stage and you stood next to the bigger guys on the show, and they go, oh,
yeah,
wow, okay, we didn't see that coming. We're like, well.
I think before this, people thought maybe you'd look like a classic guy next to someone like a Cooklow or a Rodriguez who are mass monsters. And you didn't. Yeah. You look comparable size-wise, dimension-wise.
Yeah, and you know, and this is what, you know, for our goal in the future, this is the look we want. We want to have the mass to hang around with the big mass monsters, but yet still keep our class in line, still keep the small weight, still pull the vacuum, still have the lines and everything else, so still be aesthetic even at that size. So, I mean, this is probably one of the things where our pictures, because we look so aesthetic in pictures when I stand alone, people automatically assume, oh, he looks more classic-y and everything else. But then they don't realize the size when you then do stand next to these bigger guys that, oh, wow, actually, he's classic, but he still has that mass anyway. So for us, it was like, this was definitely that tick in the box for us to finally stand next to those guys and say, okay, let's step back now. Let's have a look. Where do you really stand? How do you really look next to them, guys? And this weekend was really an answer to that question for a long time we've been wondering.
You've done a lot of big shows like Romania, you know, the Prague, which you won, you know, all these different shows. Now, this is by far the biggest event you've been in. What was it like doing your first Arnold Classic? What was the difference?
It was surreal. Arnold, by far, is the most organized and best show I've ever done. It's, you know, you hear how well the Arnold is run and how well the show is, but you really don't know how good it is until you're on the ground.
Yeah.
It was really as good as they say, and better, because I was shocked. I was just like, whoa, is this really how they really treat us athletes? Like, yeah, this show is about you guys. And, you know, we come out in the hotel, you go to the foyer, and then they march you there with security all the way backstage. And you walk in there, and you're doing a man.
Yeah.
This is surreal.
Superstars.
They march you to the expo with the security around you and stuff. And I'm like, we're looking, going, this is crazy. Like, this is just crazy. I can't believe this. This is just surreal, you know. And we're looking at going, wow. Yeah, if you've ever meant to feel special before a show going in, this is how you do it, you know. And man, we were just blown away by it, you know. And the show times, even backstage, everything, they gave us information, they kept us up to date, they told us what we had to be, they told us what we had to do, the tanning, everything was so great. And even the videos and everything else, you had so much to pick from to actually see, okay, this is what we look like, this is what we did. And it's just completely awesome show. By far the best I've ever done.
what was the fan reception like? Because now you've come in as a pro show winner and you've gone to another level. Yeah. What was it like over there in America?
Man, I was shocked because we were at the meet and greets the day before the show.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, you know, you have to be, you know, those big names are saying that. And I didn't really think I was recognized that much in the U.S. You know, I was like, well, you know, being in the U.K. my first time here, you know, I wasn't expecting much. But we were shocked when we saw the queue of people coming. Oh, man, I watch your YouTube video. Like, see you, what you do. I see what you did in Korea. And I'm like, damn, really? I did not expect that at all, you know. And that was even before we actually go on stage. And the reception of people here, they were so accepting and so, like, it was wow. I was blown away, but I was really just like, whoa, this is not what I thought was going to happen, you know. Mm. And then after the pre-judging, between that and the final, I couldn't walk past the venue without getting mobbed and stopped by people to take pictures. And I was like, man, this is, you know, you just feel like, wow, okay, all right, this is different. This is definitely different. I mean, you know, I absolutely loved it, man. The support has been absolutely immense.
So what was it like being backstage with the Brandon Currys and these guys that you've never competed against?
Yeah, oh, man, them guys, they are awesome. They're so friendly. They're so cool, you know. You know, sitting there, you know, chatting with Brandon, chatting with Bonac, you know, chatting with the guy. I'm like, you know, they're like, yeah, we know about you. You know,
they do know.
And it's surreal because it really is surreal because for years you've watched these guys, you know, compete at Olympia, compete at everything, and you sort of looked up to them and idolized them for so long. And then months later, you're literally sitting backstage with them and having a friendly chat and just everything. And you're standing going, man, I can't believe this. Like, you can't put into words how that feels, you know, being in that position. You just think this is a dream. Maybe, you know, I can't believe this happening, you know. And to have them guys so receptive and so welcoming and so friendly back towards you, what can you say? You know, you just have to take it all in and just be so grateful for that opportunity. And to be there is really just great.
Did you, obviously, because you, when I was at your house, you played me opposing music, so I knew what the opposing music was going to be, the tributes to Sean Ray, Flex Wheeler, Kevin Navrone. What was that? Did you speak to Sean Ray or Flex Wheeler? Or
I haven't seen them since, you know. I don't think...
Oh, no.
Well, you know what, man? I remember doing that routine and we came off stage and even up to now, the amount of people come to me and say, man, you really brought up memory. You really brought us, giving us flashbacks when you did that routine. We were like, they all knew, they were like, yeah, when you did the Kevin and you did the show, they were like, yeah, we love it. And I'm like, look, that's all I wanted to do, man, to make sure, you know, just give you guys, remember this time and this year, remember this physique and what they did. And just kind of get that flashback to that point. And you know what, I feel really grateful that we got an opportunity to do that on the stage of all stages as well.
So next week's the Boston Pro. Now, you said you're going home on Tuesday and then flying back out. Why have you thought, maybe, as Fuad said, maybe just stay out here or Milos? Or
the thing is, I mean, people seem to they don't understand, like, the amounts, like staying somewhere like in a hotel for a week in peak week, it really throws your body out of whack because you can't prepare your food properly. You have to get a meal prep from it. Things that you normally do that your body's so used to.
Yeah.
You don't have that luxury. The food that you're eating here is different. The training you're doing here is just not your natural environment. And as much as it is, people are, oh, yeah, but you got to fly back. Look, we've done this before so many times.
Good practice.
The best thing we've done in the past, this is a breeze. It's not even like something worth worrying about. Yeah. So, but at the same time, you know, it gives us a chance to go back to our natural environment, get restocked in our food, you know, because if we don't do that, the food we will have between this week and Boston will be all something I'm not used to eating.
Okay.
It will be all things I'm not. So we can guarantee that that wouldn't affect my physique going into the Boston next week.
Yeah.
But once we know we have control, that if we can go back, other than the 8 hours flight, which we've already seen that I don't hold water from flying. Other than that, everything else will be exactly the way it was coming to your show for the first time. You know, we will have the natural. We're back in our natural environment. We'll be back in our normal eating what we normally food we normally eat. So that would just give us a more strength going back in Boston, knowing that okay, everything is exactly the way we want planned it to be. So I know that for some people that it makes sense just to stay here and everything else. And honestly, I would have done, but kind of thinking about if you kind of weighed up the strengths and the negative and what you can make from it, we thought, you know what, it's easy just to go back. Rest of have a few days and then just fly in and just do the show because 8 hours is back.
Plus, Marlon, like I said about a job, she's got work responsibilities and obviously you need to be together, you two. So,
no, I mean, Cerberus is at home, you know.
Cerberus is the dog.
So, you know, we got a lot of responsibility that we do have to.
But also, Samson, I want to say that dog is absolutely gigantic in real life. It's like you. It looks bigger in real life.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, you know. So, yeah. Yeah, that is the same as me. Yeah, you know. So all these things, you know, you got responsibility. You have to go back, and Mel has to go back to work.
Yeah.
And, you know, we got to go back and fix service up and everything else. And then sort of polish things up for a week and then plan it for the next weekend. And, you know, these little things you have to sort of think about. It's not as much as it is. It can't just be about me.
Yeah.
I got to take into consideration all these other things about we plan the show. So for me, you know, I'm like, look, if this is what we have to do to make it work, then that's what we have to do to make it work. We just do it, you know. So I'm just like, yeah, this is not, it's not, I mean, especially compared with what we've done last year, flying from show to show, this isn't even an issue. This isn't even something.
You're well versed in it. You're used to it.
Oh yeah, I'm completely well versed in this. Yeah. So it's just like, yeah, it's a breeze. It's not even, you know, something to worry about.
Mate, as I said before, you were 3 points behind an all-time best Steve Cooklow. You're going to be going up against Steve again next week, as well as Phil Clayhar, Brett Wilkin. You probably will tighten up. You know, I mean, there's talk that you really, are you feeling confident you could go in and win the Boston? Because I tell you what, a lot of people think you could win it next week, mate.
Yeah, because the thing is, we've known from, especially from last year, we know that with every show that happens, I get better from show to show.
Yeah.
We saw it last night. We saw it this weekend.
Yeah.
Came on Saturday. Came in Friday night. It was like, whoa. Came in Saturday. Oh, he's got better. And we know that we have the ability to just get better from show to show.
Yeah.
I mean, it takes a few weeks of me doing that before I start seeing the decline of my physique. So going off and coming back next week, I can tell you now we'll be stronger than we were this week. It's just what happens.
But you know what? There is one big issue if you win next week. How the hell are you going to get the truck back?
Oh, man.
You're going to win a truck. What are you going to do? Drive it.
Oh, I carry it on my back if I have to. I'm like, yeah. Fantastic. That up for nobody. I'm like, oh, really? Oh, I'm taking that gladly. Because that would definitely be a, okay, what do you do, Bowman? I don't know. But yeah, I'll gladly welcome that. That as an issue, I'll gladly welcome.
That's, you face much bigger problems than deciding what to do with the truck and how to get it back to UK.
So yeah, man. So definitely, I mean, even the idea to have a chance to compete again in the States, you know, because this is one thing that we really wanted to be. It's not just, you know, the guy that competes in Europe, but the guy is now global. He's now international.
And
that means showing more face in the States, showing more of us, on the other side of the pond, and really kind of coming out there. We really want to capitalize on that and really have the opportunity to do that now. So for me, being in shape, 1 week of prep compared to everything, it's a breeze. Like, might as well just go do the show, man. Even do it for the fans, just do it.
Yeah.
And just enjoy the experience one more time. And then you still got, 8 months before the Olympia? So you have time to rest. And I mean, you see what, I've already shown what we can do with just 3 months.
Yeah.
Of literally straight into another prep.
Samson, it's a completely different physique that we saw in Romania. It's a completely different physique.
And this is the thing, when it comes to the Olympia, whatever physique you just see now will end up being my worst look today. And then be like, okay, next one then.
Yeah.
You know, this is how he was good, but now he's all of a sudden next level again. So we will never bring the same physique twice. We'll always constantly improve and get better. So that's one thing we know we're definitely looking forward to.
Mate, I think there's serious conversations now where people said before, okay, Samson's potential top 10 Olympia. I think with what you're doing now, I think you're going to be in the conversation for a top 6 potential. You're there now.
Man, I really appreciate it. I mean, I don't know, but you know, it's the Olympia, it's your first Olympia. You always got to be like, okay, take everything with a pinch of salt, man. Just take everything because it's still your first Olympia.
Yeah.
You know, but at the end of the day, like I said, me being in the top 10 in my first Olympia, it's more than a reward for me to walk away with of my first year. I'm like, yeah, I'll gladly smile. I'll take that. You know, thank you very much. I mean, we just did it with Arnold. First Arnold, placing top 5 in the first Arnold.
Top 4? You got to say top 4 now, not top 5.
Yeah, but being in the top 5 in the first Arnold, you know, and, you know, being the first call out is like, yo, what, how can you not be so happy with that? You know?
I messaged you after the first call out. I said, oh my God. I said, because I said, that's what I want for you. I want you to be in that first call out because I think if, you know, and you get moved to brand, because you had your next to brand and then they moved you, didn't you? And I was like, oh no. It's like,
yep, you know, and then come back the next day and then say, okay, put you next to Steve and Justin. Yeah. We were like, yes, you know, now fight, you know, come on, really fight for it now. They're giving you the opportunity for you to. So we're like, okay, let's do this, you know. So it was definitely awesome, you know. Really couldn't ask for more, you know. Seriously, it's just like, wow, this is this man. What a year! What a way to start the year.
And you beat Justin Rodriguez, who was probably like, I thought actually he was. I thought he was going to be third on, based upon how he looked on the first day, and he always seems to fade on the second day. And it was like, and you took him out. And I mean, that's the all-time best Justin Rodriguez. I mean, that guy is no joke.
I saw him in pre-judging. I was thinking, holy shit. It's a monster. Wow. You know, and then, as you know, you sort of come towards the end of the field and you saw him fading a bit. And I was like, yeah, okay, fair enough. But he might come in better tomorrow and everything else. So when we kind of came to the finals, I'm looking, actually, I think we can actually jump above him. If we really go for it, we can actually do it this time.
Fantastic.
You know, and to see that happen was like, man, okay. You know, you ended the night, the pre-judging, with you being compared for fifth place. And then by the finals, you're being compared for third.
Yeah.
So it's like...
You moved up.
That high in such a time. Like, man, really? You just can't do numbers. Wow. You know, seriously.
What a start to the end. And also, finally, is Fuad happy?
Oh, man, he's really happy.
Funny that.
Okay. Thanks. So I literally got a false photo shoot with Hostile this morning and everything else, and I couldn't be more proud of it. I'm like, look, this team came out from nowhere. He saw something in me when everybody was just sort of having a glimpse at it. He backed me up right from the get-go and said, okay, I want to give you a chance to really, I see something, I want to give you a chance to show it. And honestly, since then, I don't ever want to disappoint him. I always want to be like, okay, represent the brand properly and actually be what he knows I can be, you know. And even now he's already telling me, okay, I know you try to do this before the Olympics, try to do this, you know, try to
nice,
we really see you doing this. And you know, are you talking now, you're thinking, yeah, you know, a team that really, they don't just want you to support the brand, they want to see you do well.
Yeah,
you know, they want to help you get there. And for me, I think it's the best thing ever, and I couldn't be more grateful.
I, you notice I didn't ask if Milos was happy, because I've seen all the photos and videos. I know he's happy. I know he is, absolutely. I saw the video when you came off stage and he hugged you, and you could see he was so, so happy. It was so great to see. It was wonderful, wonderful.
Yeah, he was, you know, and Milos, man, he went over and beyond this weekend. He was completely meticulous. Every morning, first thing, he's in my hotel room to have a look at it. He'd come back in to have a look at me. Yeah. He was literally meticulously checking every detail, making sure we were on at every point, you know. And he was, you could tell he was tired, he was ragged, but he was really giving us our all, you know. He was bouncing, going back between me and Regan, and really making sure that we really kind of captured. And he gave his whole energy to us this weekend. And honestly, I couldn't be more grateful to him, man. He really just blew us away with how, when he's, it's one thing, you know, when you do it by phone and Skype doing your showtime, but when you actually have him there and he actually can stand in front of you and look at you and say, okay, we need this, we need that, we need this. And he would literally almost take the radicals and really kind of zoom in and look at everything. Okay, we need more, this more. And he really played our role, and he really helped us out big time this weekend.
Because, of course, that's the first time you've actually physically met him, isn't it?
Yeah. The first time
we really physically met him. Crazy, isn't it? And he's such a big part of your life, and it's the first time you've physically seen him.
Yeah, you know, and it was just like, wow, you know. He kind of looked at me like, yeah, finally, you know. It feels like we've already had this relationship already building up. So at this point, it was just like, man, wow. Officially make it there, you know. But yeah, he was absolutely awesome.
Samson, I'm going to let you go. I'm going to be mindful of your time. Let you get some breakfast or something. But mate, we're very proud of you. The UK fans are just, and the whole, it's not just UK now. Like you said, you are global now. You're truly global. You were really one of the real highlights of the Arnold Classic, you know, to finally, like, I keep going back to those couple of years ago, everything you've been through, everything, all that traveling last year to try and get on points, and then you got the qualification for the Olympia, then you got the invitation to the Arnold, then you got fourth place, and it's like, and everyone's talking about you, and you brought it when it really counted, you know?
Yeah, you know, thanks so much, man. And honestly, with all the work and all the people that I've had supporting me and really showing me support through the time, you know, when they were bad, when they were, I was down, they would say, keep your head up, your time will come. Yeah. You know, just keep going, your time will come. They will see you. I just wanted to thank you to all of them, man, because you guys really kept me going when I just thought, man, maybe this wasn't for me. Maybe I just don't have what it takes. And to have them say, look, just keep going. Don't worry, keep going. You will have your chance. And now that it's happening, you just feel so grateful to those people that really did, like, support you right from the get-go. And they saw something right from that point saying, look, you will make it. Just keep hanging in there. And now seeing it happen now, man, I couldn't be more grateful and say thank you to all of you that support me.
Samson, one final thing. I mean, just so popped into my head. This time last year, you told me, I think it was after you'd done Yamamoto, and you said, like, this time, well, literally this time about a year ago, you were, like, struggling with confidence, and then John Meadows, and then Milos and Fuad came into the picture, and obviously Malenka, your huge support there. You're a big shout-out to Malenka.
Yep.
Malenka! Where is she? There she is!
Stealing him, James, because we are late.
Okay, sorry, Samson, guys, I'm so sorry. I'm going to let you go.
Probably my feet. So I'm so sorry, but I do have to steal him.
Okay. Right, guys, I'll let you go. But thank you so much for doing this very, very, sort of last minute interview. I really appreciate it. But fantastic job, mate. And all the best for Boston Pro, mate. I'll be texting you.
Thank you very much, man. Really appreciate it, man. Thank you guys so much.
Great job, mate. Great job, guys.
Thanks, man. See you later.
Speak to you soon. Bye-bye.
Hi guys, welcome back. Global Muscle here in the Giant studio today, the Giant Slayer for legs. Giles wanted to film this, so I'm staying the intro at the start of the workout before I'm too breathless to say anything. Warm up, we're doing some leg extensions and some line leg curls. Get everything warmed up, and I think we're going into some heavy safety bar squats, and then we'll be going into a Giant set. This is a normal gym session for me. Lee's the man, he controls the sessions. I don't really know what's going off. My main concern is getting enough oxygen in to keep the heart pumping and keep breathing. So you'll see me out of breath through the session. If I look like I'm dying, don't panic. It's a common thing. We'll be right back.
Let's go.
That's a start. Ooh. Drop set, leg extension. Drop set, hamstring curl. We'll definitely get some warm, get some blood in there. Ooh. What's next? Progressively heavier, so we do three of these or two. Yeah, so that one was heavier than the last, which is nicer. Not. Oh! 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7.
This is getting me out of breath. This is zero sugar. Tap now to win exclusive passes. Just getting the QR code onto the next pack.
See me sweating. This is just getting the sleeves on.
Feel the magic with Coca-Cola Zero Sugar.
Feel the magic. Oh, no, yeah. Saved it.
Win.coca-cola.co.uk.
I never knew I'd be so good at engineering. You're so inspired.
Concentration phase.
It's something that I can do every day to make such changes.
It's like you're fast-tracking me with all the crocket industry.
The choice, though. He's sweating more than he did when he's...
Hello.
Come on, let's go have a go.
This is a set. This is a set before the set.
Teaching further education and change lives without changing your career. Share your skills. Search Teach in Further Education.
I think this is the biggest ones they do, Giles.
Yo, what's happening?
4x7.
Step into a world of music made just for you. Premium is your music.
Rover's return for a pint.
Listening once we get to know you, we release new mixes based on what you love. From daily mixes to Discover Weekly, Premium is
to
download those playlists and listen
colour,
offline.
Colourless edition.
Enjoy ad-free music. What are you waiting for? Join Premium today.
How's your colour then?
There, these are leaves. Knee sleeves.
Well, thank you. What a piece of shit.
Oh man, okay.
Oh man, this straight in.
Yep.
Let's go, one. Let's go. Two, three, four.
sweaty.
It's all for show, Giles.
It's not real. That's a joke. Oh, man.
What's funny now? Good. 10.
Don't know drugs.
That was a trick question on camera.
Yeah.
My jacket. Hamstrings.
I need to go hamstrings. I don't really look like Dennis Wolf if I don't go hamstrings. That hamstring drop, that's impressive. We need it.
We need that big belly hamstrings.
Yeah. I don't believe in the Brazilian butt lift, so I've got to do it manually. Manual labour. No silicone. Ooh.
Oh, yeah. Good. Oh. Hell yeah, man. Oh. Let's go. Oh. Ah. Let's go. Oh. Oh. Let's go. Oh. Ah. Oh. Ah. Oh. Ah. Come on, last one. Let's go.
Okay, guys, it's time for our Arnold Classic Hot News Special. I did want to do a live stream review, actually going through the evening finals routines, but the live stream's still going on because I think the strongman, so it's still, so basically I can't access it. So we're just going to do a kind of a, like a normal type hot news going through, obviously, the popular Instagram account, just basically see what's what and get some good visuals for the Arnold Classic this weekend. Fantastic to have it back in March as well. And by all accounts, it was a huge success. And it's good to see the shows back on their kind of regular slot now. Now, obviously, the big news was it was won by Brandon Curry. A bit controversial, this one. As you can see, I mean, Brandon looks great here. But William Bonac was the kind of overwhelming favourite and fan favourite to win this. Not in the lead up, but based upon how he looked at the show, I think many had him becoming a three-time Arnold Classic winner. He won it in 2018, 2020. He was second to Brandon Curry in 2019. And this is, as you can see, this is not Brandon Curry at his best. I mean, I don't think Brandon even looks as good as he did here than he did it 2019 when I saw him narrowly. He just beat William Bonac at this one. But as you can see, the condition, as you saw in the review with Ron Harris, it seemed that he got out to QA a little bit later than maybe his coach Abdullah would have liked. And yeah, he was a little bit I don't think he's smaller here. I think he's just not popping because he's not as in good a condition. But like this, all this, see, I mean, I would think at the 2020 Olympia, not when he won in 2019, but at the 2020 Olympia is when I really feel that Brandon kind of really started getting the separation. And oh yeah, he's really not in good condition here. I think this was the prejudging. And he did sharpen full out a little bit for the finals, but I mean he's 80% there. 80% in terms of condition, isn't he? He's not sharp. He was sharper at the Olympia last year when he lost the prejudging by 1 point to defending and 2-time Olympia champion Big Ramy. But I mean he looks a few weeks out there, doesn't he? I mean, front, I mean, the upper body, the shoulders, I mean, they're nice and full and round, but to me, he looks a couple of weeks out there, at least. I think he looks like 3 good weeks of prep out. So if he'd have got to Kuwait maybe 3-4 weeks earlier, I think we would have seen Brandon at normal Brandon of what we've seen in the last 2 years. But he's just, I mean, he's nowhere near as good as when he won the 2019 Arnold Classic. I was sat there front row next to Arnold. Well, 20 seats away. I could see him in the distance through my goggles. Telescope. But yeah, so a little bit of a controversial win. Like I said, there's not many people that had Brandon winning this. And, you know, I mean, he's an Olympia champion. He's won the Arnold Classic. He's the currently ranked the number 2 in the world. But William Bonac was, like Ron said in the in the review, you know, we all thought a lot of us would be forgiven for kind of writing William Bonac off. He slipped to, was it 5th the year before? Then he went to 6th. And we thought this was a decline. But now there's a serious conversation for William Bonac. Now working with Chad Nichols, only 5 weeks they worked together for the Arnold Classic. So imagine with Chad. I wonder how that's going to work with Chad Nichols working with Big Ramy and William Bonac. I wonder if that affects things. But no, actually, Chad Nichols, back in the 90s, I think there was 1 year in the Olympia, he had 5 of the top 6 guys he was prepping. So he is used to prepping. There is no conflict of interests with him working with multiple athletes. So he's basically, because the last few years, Chad Nichols has only really just worked with a small handful of clients. But it seems now that he's going back to what he did 20, 30 years ago and working with more than one. I mean, he worked with Flex Wheeler, Ronnie Coleman, Nasser Sambati, Paul Dillette, I believe he worked with. You know, and these were the guys that were filling out the top 6 of the Olympia. So it'd be interesting to see how you know, William Bonac will look, actually. Maybe back at his all-time best at the Olympia this year. But and I hope to see Brandon looking better than this, than at the Olympia, because this was disappointing. Yeah, especially when you see this Gilco Productions high quality kind of footage. You know, you can see that he really wasn't in his best condition. I was actually expecting Brandon to really pull it out of the bag for the Saturday and really come in dry and full, but it really didn't really happen. There wasn't much of a difference. So yeah, as you can see by the comments, yeah, I don't know how he won with his conditioning. Yeah, so yeah, I can feel that. And I'm a huge Brandon fan, on the front cover of the latest MD. So yeah, so let's go see what else is on here. William Bonac also won the Most Muscular Award, which is usually 9 times out of 10. It's a consolation prize. It means you've got second. And it did. Yeah, so I mean, I'm sure that $10,000 didn't really do much to, you know, quell his disappointment, really. Robbery. Yeah, people are really annoyed with this one. I mean, let's have a look at this content. Yeah, as you can see, I mean, look at the difference in the legs, the upper body. I mean, Brandon has got a beautiful V-shape. I mean, the V-shape, I mean, look at that. I mean, his upper body is so round and full. But the thing is, when you're not crisply separated, because Brandon has always struggled with muscle separation and those deep cuts. So he needs to be as lean and as dry as possible to look his best. Or, I mean, if you compare Brandon's leg to William's legs, I mean, you know, the difference in separation and definition is much more pronounced in William Bonac. So, and also I'm seeing a bit more going on in William's arms this year. He did his Most Muscular slightly different. He did like a hands on hips one. And it really suited him. And I'm disappointed for William. And it's great to see when these guys come back as well, because many of us did think that, you know, William was on the slide. He had a leg injury a couple of years ago, and he struggled with the size in this leg in 2019 for the 2019 Olympia. And you could see there was a clear, even though he got second to the Olympia that year, there was a clear disparity between the left leg and the right leg. But, you know, the legs look great here again. And, Brandon, yeah. I hope to see Brandon looking better than this at Olympia because, I mean, going into the lead-up before this show, I thought Brandon was going to be winning the Arnold Classic and the Olympia this year. But unless he gets out to Q8, I mean, like Ron Harris said, a good 16 weeks before, he won't win the Olympia. And I think he has the goods to do so again, like he did in 2019 by winning the Arnold Classic and the Olympia. So, but I bet he's happy that he's won it. So, okay, what else we got? What else we got? Here, let's have a look at the Gilco Productions footage of William. Yeah, it looks really good. Looks sharp. I'm just wondering whether this is William at his absolute best or whether it's just better than what he brought last year. Because, I mean, yeah, this chest looked a bit atrophied last year, but it looks nice and full here. So I just wonder what the hell he's done with Chad Nichols in just 5 weeks. It's absolutely incredible. Absolutely incredible to see an athlete that was, you know, starting, well, clearly over 2 years, 2020 and 2020 Olympia, was clearly starting to slide, and he's managed to come back to looking pretty much almost to his best. So, and I think if people forget that William Bonnick won the 2020 Arnold Classic, beating Dexter Jackson and Big Ramy. So, you know, let's not forget how good William Bonnick is, because he is such an impressive athlete. I remember when I was hyping him back in 2012, when he was a 212, and I was interviewing him in the at the British Grand Prix. So, yeah, he looks absolutely fantastic. That's his worst pose, the front last spread. So, okay then. Who else we got? Let's have a look at... Oh, this was interesting. This was on the pre-judging the first day. Seeing Brett Wilking versus Samson Dauda. This was pretty much them deciding for fifth and sixth. But Samson actually ended up coming fourth on the Saturday. So it shows that Samson probably got better and Justin Rodriguez kind of got worse. Justin Rodriguez obviously peaked at the pre-judging. But I think it's a strong show. I think it's a good showing for Brett Wilking. Maybe not what many expected. I think he can tighten up a lot. And I think I'd like to see him do he was doing the Boston Pro. Let's see what he can do in a week. Let's see if he can tighten up even more. So, yeah. The hamstrings, if you've noticed, if we could zoom right in. Can we zoom right on there? Samson's got more deeper separation in his hamstrings now. Have you noticed? A lot like Regan Grimes. Maybe it's a Milos thing. So, but what a fantastic result for Samson Dauda there. I mean, fourth place in his first Arnold Classic. You know, just coming off his first pro win at the Prague last year. And if you followed this guy's career, you know, he's been on many, many times on Global Muscle. You'll see this guy is, you know, he's been through it. You know, he's been through it. And, well, we all know the stories about career and all that. And wanting to trying to get to the Tampa Pro in 2020. Refused to get on the flight. But I think Brett's legs are good. I think, yeah, I would like to see Brett do more shows this year. And I'd like to see him tighten up. Maybe drop a few pounds. And... he's lacking separation, isn't he, in condition? It's just condition. I think he's just condition. We could see him maybe do a few more shows and see how he looks. But, so Samson, fourth place. This was, many have said this is an all-time best Steve Cooklow. A little bit lighter than he was at the Arnold Classic when he came third. You think looks good? Looks great, doesn't he? I wonder how much lighter he was. Oh, he's 10... He's 10 pounds lighter than the last show. Yeah.
He looks fantastic.
And the conditioning.
Yeah, this looks good.
He looks good, doesn't he? Looks nice and full. I don't know. It's I've seen photos and he does look... Is this the best Steve Cooklow we've seen?
It's the best I've seen of him.
Oh, okay. I think the best you've seen him. Yeah. Okay. I liked his Arnold Classic look last year. But does the 10 pounds off make him look better or not better? Sorry?
Makes him look harder.
Okay. I'd have to maybe get the Arnold Classic, because obviously the last Arnold Classic was only 6 months ago, and literally compare them side by side to see if he looks better lighter, because sometimes a lot of bodybuilders don't actually look better heavier, they actually look better lighter, because it brings out the lines, it's small, it makes the waist smaller, it brings up the muscle separation. What were you saying, Laura?
Much better.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, it looks...
Yeah, the waist is
smaller. Yeah, tan looks a bit muddy. Is it just because it's the really high quality footage and it's really up close? Is this maybe... Because in other photos, I thought the tan looked great, but it looks a bit patchy and a bit muddy. But yeah, I think maybe it's just the footage... there you go. There's Samson. Yeah, look at that front of a bicep. I mean, this is a guy that is 280 pounds. I mean, that is... He could still get harder. I mean, look at the vacuum, the tiny waist. As he's added size, his waist has not grown. He's actually maintained this tiny little waist. Yeah, that's a good shot. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. Like I said, I stayed at his house 2 weeks ago. And he posed for me and I was absolutely blown away. I couldn't believe what I was looking at. Incredible. The side chest is where I noticed he's a lot more fuller in the upper chest. The legs are bigger. There's more in the arms. So actually that pose really highlights the improvements he's made in just the last few months. I mean, Samson said in the interview in this episode that he was 10 pounds heavier than when he won in Prague. So if he was 270 there, he's 280 here, say. So, or give or take a couple of pounds. A little more detail from the back and he'll be fighting for that top three. Should be top four. Well, he was top four. Came fourth place. So he climbed from, it looked like he was fifth place, or maybe even sixth place, you know, if I think it was, a solid fifth place lock. And then based upon how Justin slipped and how Samson did on the Saturday, he climbed up to fourth place. So fourth place is an absolutely incredible achievement for Samson Dauda. So let's, what else? Let's have a look. Oh, this is Andrew Jacked as well, who won the new pro that won the amateur super heavyweight and overall. So he's now a new IFBB pro. Is that a pector? No, looks like a bit of a pector. Possibly. Yeah, it looks great. I think he's been out in Dubai. He looks like Rolly Winkler. Yeah, he does a bit. Doesn't he? He does look a bit like him. He looks ready to have his debut and get an Olympic qualifier. No, not yet. Not yet. This guy is a work in progress, but he is going to... I'm sure Andrew Jacked will be an incredible pro. There he is with Flex Wheeler and George Farah. So he's got a pretty good team there behind him. So they are doing a selfie. He looks very happy. So, yeah, so his first outing, I believe, in the NPC. And straight away, he has got his pro card. And he will be, I would imagine he'll be doing the Arnold Classic next year as a pro. I would literally shut it down now until the Olympia next year. But very nice physique. He's a very tall guy as well. He's creating a lot of noise. He was training at the Dragon's Lair. There's a lot of videos, a lot of hype around this guy. And he delivered. So he lived up to the hype. So is Andrew Jacked on Instagram? I can't remember his real name, but he's doing that thing again. Oh, hang on, it's all right. Oh, Breon, yeah, Breon, Breon, fourth place. Looked great, as good as he's ever looked. I think there's a little bit of atrophy in the legs there. There's a little bit of sarcopenia or something when the legs start to atrophy. But I mean, he was hard. He was conditioned, separated. I mean, look at the deep separations there. I mean, Brandon Curry hasn't got leg separations like that. Very, 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 very strong from the back. But these two new guys, Ramon Dino, they call him, and Urs Kalasinski, you know, this is terrible footage. This is obviously taking a cell phone on somebody's laptop. So, yeah, we'll get off this. And what else? Oh, it's doing that thing. His trackpad's very sensitive now. So, oh, it's doing that thing again. It's annoying me now. Oh, no. Oh, hang on. Right, okay then, and here we have Regan Grimes and Max Charles. Disappointing on both. But this is apparently Regan Grimes had COVID at so many weeks out, which made training and cardio very, very difficult. It looks as good as he's ever looked. I didn't really see any significant improvements, but maybe Regan will do some more shows and maybe we'll see a bit more improvements for him. He's a work in progress, Regan. I mean, he's still only 28, 29, but not as good as when he came second to Sean Clarida at the Legion Sports Festival. I've just liked it accidentally. So, yeah, I mean, what a physique. Great symmetry. Here's a guy that, like Samson, you know, could just make those necessary improvements and he will be knocking on, you know, top placings. Very aesthetic, very big. Look at that lovely shape, beautiful shape, great symmetry, great proportions, great teeth. Yeah, this is not the same guy that came second at the Legion Sport last November. He beat Sergio. And so, okay, we're going to go to our next, go to Sulio's. And this is a really good shot of Samson Dauda. I think that's where you see, that's what I was talking about to Ron, the width in the arms. I saw this at his house when I stayed at his house a couple of weeks ago. And his legs and his arms are much, much bigger if you look at old pictures. I think this is definitely the best package, and I think we'll see even a better package for the Boston Pro next week. And let's have a look. Oh, this was the footage of Regan looking crazy full. This was 7 hours before prejudging. Maybe he's got a pump, he's got some food in him there. But we'll get off this. We've just had a look at Regan. And yeah, William Bonack. So yeah, it looks fantastic. There you have the up till last night, the then current Arnold Classic champion, Nick Walker, fifth place at the Olympia. He skipped the Arnold Classic this year because he just wants to go through to the Olympia and he wants to win the Olympia. Probably one of the biggest fan bases in the world. Let's have a look at this footage of Brandon Curry winning, shaking hands with his fans. That's awesome. Who's this guy with a mask? Oh, they're still wearing masks. Still wearing masks out there. In the UK, we have no masks anymore. Just Batman masks. So, yeah, he's got a lovely physique, Brandon. It's just, this is Brandon at 80, 85%. You know, so hopefully we'll see him back to his absolute best in December at the Olympia, because we want to see him give Rami hell. You know, we want to see a really good battle again. You know, so Brandon at his best will be a contender for that Olympia title for his second Sandow. So, okay then. So what else is there? Anything else on here? Anything else interesting? No, I think that's it. Let's have a look at this prejudging footage. Let's have a look. Wow, there's Samson next to Rodriguez, Justin Rodriguez. Yeah, Justin came up very, very strong at the prejudging on the first day. I thought Justin had solid third. I thought Steve Kuklo would be fourth, Samson would be fifth. Justin Rodriguez, as he did last September, faded, and Samson kind of just held it or got better. I don't really think Samson got much better on the second day, but he certainly did enough, you know, to pull ahead of Justin Rodriguez. But to take a scalp like Justin Rodriguez, that is absolutely huge for him. So, and Steve Kuklo there looking... I'm just trying to work out whether I like Steve Kuklo's slightly heavier look more. I don't know. I think I like his last year's Arnold Classic, last September's Arnold Classic a bit better, look a bit better. I do, actually. I think he looks better, slightly bigger. I don't think it's really helped his physique because he's in the same condition he was last year and 10 pounds lighter, supposedly. You like it? You like it? Okay. Let's have a look at this. Here we are. I did say to Samson, I wanted to see him next to Brandon. So at least he did it in the pose down, even if it was just for a couple of poses. Max standing there just chilling. Let's have a look. Oh, wow, he's in the same pose next to Brandon. That is awesome. I wonder if this... I'm guessing this was for the night show because they don't have the numbers on. Have you noticed? Because they have the numbers on for the prejudging. Has he got his numbers on? Yes, they have. No. Yes. No. No, they haven't. Yeah. I tell you what, Samson looks really good, doesn't he, next to Brandon? It's a shame he didn't get compared right next to him. Even just to, you know, just to see how far he's got to go to go up to that level of the... you know, the top two Olympia guys, you know, because he's knocking on that top six by coming 3 points just behind Steve Kuklo. He really is knocking on those kind of those top six Olympia guys now. So that's a huge level up for Samson. I'm disappointing Brandon. Yeah. I want to see him back at his best. I think we'll see him back at his best at the Olympia this year. Brandon and William as well, both 39. So they're kind of hitting their peak now, these next couple of years. God, Bonax have been around 11 years now. So, yeah, Samson looks so good. I'm so impressed. I'm so glad he looked his best at the show this big. So, anyway, we're going to speed this up a little bit. Okay, it's William Bonack. Yeah, he's very disappointed. Let's have a look at these pictures. Yeah, these are nice pictures. Yeah. A bit washed out, though, in these photos. I think he was... Do you know what I like to see on Bonack? That. Have you seen the little lines? It looks like the skin is tearing. He's so lean and he's so tight. He gets it on his on this between his quad and his ham there. It literally looks like the skin is little micro tears because his skin is so thin and so tight. Absolutely phenomenal, phenomenal showing. Yeah, I think he deserved this one. I think William Bonnick really did deserve this one. So yeah, fantastic. So yeah, he's going to be disappointed with that. But also, William Bonnick is doing the Boston Pro, so it'd be interesting to see Samson, Brett Wilkin, Phil Clayhar, and all these guys, and the Justin Mackey, who we had on a couple of episodes ago. It's going to be really exciting to see all these guys going at it again. Who's you know, because these guys can really improve in a very short space of time. Some guys can get worse. William Bonnick always looks his best at the big show, and then he tends to fade, whereas some guys can actually get better. So it'll be interesting to see. You know, Justin Rodriguez might get better. William Bonnick might regress. So, you know, it's very, very close between these top six guys. So, yeah, very, be very interesting to see what happens there. Let's have a look at this one shot here. Yeah, he looks fantastic there, doesn't he? Yeah. Yeah, his arms look a bit. Maybe it's just because he's hitting the pose differently. But, yeah, awesome. Awesome. Fantastic. Fantastic look there for William. So, I'm going to go to Gilco Productions. They do the really nice, high-quality footage. Oh, we've actually just seen these anyway, so it's not really much point. So let's just have a quick look at Terence Ruffin, now the two-time Arnold Classic winner. And yeah, look at that. I mean, he is classic, isn't he? I mean, he's just the best poser in the industry right now. It's not even close. And I'm glad he obviously, well, duh, he won the best poser. So yeah, super sharp. I wonder how many pounds he is before he reaches the classic limit. I think he must be close. He must be close. It's his back shots, isn't it? He's actually harder from the back and crisper from the back than he is from the front. I mean, the glutes and the hams. I mean, that's just, there's just no skin left on those, is there? Absolutely incredible. Look at that. Very, I love the artistry of his posing and the way he presents himself and the way he angles his body. And I mean, look at that. It's incredible. I mean, this guy would have been top three Mr. Olympia 30 years ago. You know, he would have been in that first call out in the Mr. Olympia. You know, beautiful, isn't it? Incredible. Incredible. Yeah. So let's have a look at one more. Lots of ladies on this one. Let's have a look at Urs. 23 years old, Ron Harris said. I was hoping Urs would get second, but Ramondino really pulled it out of the bag for the night show. But it was very, very close. I mean, the top four classic, you had Breon Ansley in fourth, Urs in third, Ramondino in second, and of course you had the winner, Terence Ruffin. But it was very, very close between that top four. I mean, Terence was a convincing winner, but I mean, you know, the second, third and fourth really could have gone any way. But it's funny because me and Ron always say about the argument for muscle maturity, and then you get someone who's 23 with grainy, hard, dense, detailed muscle. And it completely throws that theory out of the window. So look at that. It's his legs. Just watch his legs. Does he ever relax them? I mean, he's literally got them permanently flexed. It's incredible. His control of his physique is very, very impressive. And he's making it look effortless as well. I mean, do you think his legs are just like that when he's asleep? Do you think they're just constantly... Do you think they're just locked all the time? I mean, they look rock hard, don't they? Absolutely phenomenal. 23 years old. I think he's still got, I think, 7 pounds before he hits the classic limit. It's Brandon, we've seen that one. So, oh, it's doing that thing again. That's annoying. Right, okay, I'm going to go on to the final one because we're going to wrap this up now. Of course, we've got the Boston Pro next week. This is going to be an absolutely huge event. I forget the prize money for first. I'm sure it's $30,000 and they're giving away a truck. Yeah, quite an expensive truck for first place. There's been no expense spared on this event. They've got Jay Cutler, Phil Heath, Ronnie Coleman, Brandon Curry. Brandon Curry's not competing, but he will be there doing the meet and greet. Akon, I know what they've paid for Akon for, I think it was 20 minutes, 30 minutes or something performing, or was it an hour or something? I don't know. But I know what they've paid just to get this famous rapper, singer. Name one of his songs.
Smack That.
Smack That. I don't know his music. I'm sorry. I only listen to Five Finger Death Punch. Oh, is that? I don't know. You're singing it so badly. I don't know. Well, you've been driving through the night, so yeah. I thought Lauren was going to not make it home last night. She got home about 5 o'clock in the morning, because traveling back from London, and then the popo,
yeah.
Damn popo, you're an outlaw now.
They gave you a breathalyzer.
It breathalyzed you, yeah. Oh, but did energy drinks bring up anything on the?
No.
Did the caffeine reading on the breathalyzer go through the? Anyway, it doesn't matter. Oh, you're a fugitive. Did you escape? Is there a bounty on your head now? Gonna have Boba Fett coming after you. You can come in warm or you can come in cold. It's up to you. Anyway, I digress. Yes, so anyway, I just want to give obviously the Boston Pro, the first Boston Pro. Absolutely, it's going to be an absolutely incredible event. I think it's going to be like a bit of a mini Arnold, this one. And I hope this show is really well attended and really well supported, and I hope that it carries on, because I got a feeling this is going to be an incredible event. You know, like they do the Texas Pro and all these other Legion Sport, you know, these huge events with big expos, and you know, so I just hope the East Coast really supports that, because you know, you've got Flex Wheeler, Dexter Jackson, Brandon Curry, Ronnie Coleman, Phil Heath, Jay Cutler, Akon, you know, so it's going to be absolutely incredible. And they're doing a really good job, as you can see, of really promoting the athletes. And I mean, look at that. I like to see the competitors getting, you know, their individual sort of posts and love, you know. We've got Yurishna, we've got Nicole Zobanobi Graven competing in the figure and the wellness. Who else have we got? Darwin. I like this guy's physique. Darwin Ubeeb. Uribe. Prep by Patrick Tour. I messaged Patrick yesterday when I was watching him. I think he got 8th place in the classic at the Arnold. And he needs a little bit more size, but again, like Terrence, that beautiful classic lines. Really nice. Very nice physique. So, yeah. And also, we got Nate Spear making his pro debut. We have Justin Mackey competing. Justin Rodriguez. We've got, who else we got? Who else? Divine Wilson there in the classic. Any more open guys? Phil Clayhar, very interesting. I really wish they'd get... I bet the Arnold Committee really wishes they'd given Phil Clayhar an invite to the Arnold Classic now. Because he wanted to do it, and then all the guys dropping out. I think he'd have done really well. He could have been... I think he could have beat Brett. He would have beat Brett. He'd have been 6th. So I think they missed a trick there by not inviting the Jamaican Tank. Because he really wanted to do it as well. And he looked incredible last year when he took 3rd place at the Texas Pro. And he's just improving. One of the best backs in the Pro League right now as well. So anyway, yeah. So we've gone through this many times. But yeah, so next week will be all about the Boston Pro. And yeah, so I hope you've enjoyed this Arnold Classic kind of special episode. And check out the latest of the champ. Is it that way? That way? That way? That way? That way, that way. Anyway, yeah, so the latest issue of MD there, really good issue. Already working on the 1-2 after now. So, yeah. Okay, guys. Okay, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. And tonight, I'm very excited because we're going to see Batman. And it's been really difficult to avoid all the spoilers. I'm not going to lie. Because it came out on Friday in the UK and I'm not going to get to see it till it's Sunday today. So, yeah, I've been trying to, like, when I see any posts about reviews, I try to just scroll past them as quickly as possible. So, yeah, but what an Arnold Classic. I hope to be back there next year. Because the last show I went to in America was the 2020 Arnold Classic, and then the whole pandemonium happened. And also a big shout out to Vlad Suhorochko, Ukrainian bodybuilder. Obviously, his friends and family in Ukraine, obviously very, very serious situation there. So I want to send some love and support there to Vlad, because obviously he's actually in Dubai or Kuwait prepping out there. So, but he's obviously, I've spoke to him and he's very, very stressed out at the moment. So yeah, so I hope he's okay, and I hope your family is safe, and I hope you're all going to be okay. Very, very difficult situation out there. So, okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and we will be back next week with our Boston Pro special. And once again, thank you for watching, thank you for supporting, and ladies and gentlemen, we are out.